everyone. Great to have you here today. I'm super excited to be back after a week, and a lot of you guys are coming back to join me today. So thank you so much for remembering. I actually forgot to, I posted the link of the video early this morning, but I forgot to make it a public link. So sorry for getting the information out to you late today. I made it public at about 11 o'clock so you guys could see it. So anyway, I love how everyone is showing up in the chat early. It's so much fun to see all the comments flying back and forth. People are really getting to be friends in the chat here, so it's a lot of fun. And Jack, I love the fact that you are, what'd you call it, a bird wrangler or something like that. But anyway, you help rehab animals. So that is wonderful. And I know you have to go in about 20 minutes to feed your baby birds. So we'll try and get through some information before you have to jump off. But thanks so much for joining me. There's people here from South Africa, which is super exciting, all over the United States, from San Francisco, from Maryland. Let me just take a look in the chat here to see where everybody is from. Say hello if you haven't yet. Oh, here we see Anastasia from Phoenix. Cindy, great to see you too. Pat Sella, I love having you come back every week. And Pat Sella, thank you so much. She's saying kudos to Camera Guy for his camera work on the garden tour. It was one of my favorite. That is awesome. Camera Guy does such an amazing job, and you guys have to check out his Instagram. He's at Cali Camera Guy on Instagram. He's got some great photos. He posted some wonderful photos from our trip to Oregon. We were there for my niece's wedding and it was absolutely lovely. But today, guys, let's get right into it. Our topic is basil. So basil is one of the most popular and by far my favorite herb to grow. It's so, so easy to grow. And just a few little facts about basil is it's a warm weather herb. So summertime, spring, summer, and into the fall is a great time to plant it. It's an annual, which means when it starts to get cold, like in the winter time when things frost or things just get really cold, it dies off. So get your basil planted. It's not too late to plant it now for a late summer and fall harvest. So wonderful herb to grow. Probably one of the most popular varieties is this variety right behind me here, which is called Genovese. It's a sweet basil, super, super tasty, and that's probably what you see most likely at the grocery stores is the Genovese basil. And I just harvested some this morning, actually. Some of this I harvested about a week ago and put in this cute little vase. So it keeps really nicely on the windowsill. It's easy to prune and propagate, which we'll talk about in just a moment. Another variety I absolutely love, let me pull one down here, is this purple basil. And I've actually started some brand new seedlings here for a late summer planting. So you definitely wanna get pick up one of my late summer garden seed kits if you haven't yet, because there's some varieties in there that will mature and grow from seed to harvest in about 6 weeks. And basil is one of them. So get some new basil planted. That way when your summer basil is kind of starting to go to seed and maybe looking not so hot, you'll have some brand new seedlings to take its place. So pick up one of those seed collections. There's also some cucumbers in there, some squash, beans, basil, and my Thumbelina zinnias. So question, difference in taste between the purple and the Genovese. I don't really see a big difference in taste, but the purple basil is absolutely beautiful, don't you think? So it really makes a nice little color splash in the garden. So how we're gonna do the live stream today, if you're not familiar with, is I'm gonna give a couple of tips or a tip or two, and then we're gonna jump back into the chat and answer some questions. So hang on to your questions, and if you can, keep your questions to basil today, but you can ask questions about anything, and I'll try and get through what I can. So the first tip for growing basil, guys, basil is so easy to grow, and one of the most wonderful things you can do to get more growth, first tip, is to prune your basil. And pruning is also a great way to get a harvest. So, but the more you prune your basil, the more it will grow. And it really, by pruning it, you're helping it to grow nice and bushy instead of tall and lanky with those long stems. So it's really easy to do, guys. I actually have a really great video I posted last summer called A 2-Minute Tip on how to have an endless supply of basil. So I'm gonna put that link in the video description. And if Christy, if you happen to have it, if you could pop it in the chat, that would be great. Oh, and by the way, everything sunflowers is moderating today. Sorry, I forgot to mention that. She's doing a great job. So she may be popping some things in the chat here as we go along. So guys, basil is super, super easy to prune. Let me just turn my camera here so you can see. When you're pruning basil, what you wanna do is go beneath the first set of leaves here. So see how basil grows in sets. You've got two leaves going off in either direction, two leaves right here. So you simply go beneath the first set of leaves and clip the stem off. That's all you have to do. So just cut it off, and you can do that all around your plant to get a nice little harvest. It will encourage new growth. And here I've got a couple more I'm gonna snip off here for you guys. So you can see these leaves smell so, so good. So it's a good idea to prune your basil about once a week or so. Just go out to your garden, prune it off. It will encourage new growth. And the cool thing about it is, where you pruned here, see this little tip where I pruned? You're gonna see new leaves develop in about a week or so. So basil grows in sets of two leaves. So you'll see two new leaves start to grow, and then you're just gonna have tons and tons of basil. It will continue to grow all summer long that way. So especially when you see your basil starting to flower, I don't know if I have any basil flowering right now. Let me pull out one of the ones I cut last week and see how this little flower is starting to develop in the middle. It just looks like little flowers actually are starting to grow from the middle. You want to try and prune it before it flowers, because that way once it flowers, the stems tend to get a little bit woody and the flavor of the leaves change. So go out to your garden, don't be afraid to prune out your basil, and you can leave a couple of them to flower if you want, because the bees really do like the flowers. But by pruning your basil, it's really gonna help you grow a ton of basil in your garden. So we're gonna hold off on the second tip while I head to the chat and answer a couple of questions. So yeah, Yvette, it's a great way to help your basil just really be super, super prolific. Okay, I've got my computer off here to the side, so I'm gonna look off the side for a little bit, answer some questions, and then we'll come back for the second tip. So, okay here, question. From Jack, before you have to go out to feed your baby birds. This is a great question, Jack. My local store has basil plants, but there's 20 plants in one 3-inch pot. Is it a good idea to divide it up? 20 plants is a lot for a 3-inch pot. So yes, I would recommend dividing it up. You can grow in this pot, I think I have probably 3 or 4 plants growing, so you can grow it very close together, but it's definitely gonna produce a lot more leaves if you divide it up. And it's so easy to divide up. You don't have to be afraid about, damaging it or anything. I mean, of course you wanna be kind of careful when you pull it apart, but you can definitely divide it up, and then you'll have lots and lots of basil plants. So great question, Jack. Thanks a lot for bringing that up. Oh, Santa Ana Road Wildman, it's great to see you here. I know sometimes you're working during a live stream, so I'm really glad that you could make it today. And question from you. Oh dear, it just scrolled away from me. I'm sorry guys, the chat is scrolling along very, very quickly today, so I'm very sorry if I missed your question. Oh, here we go. My thyme are getting flowers on the ends. Should I prune? Absolutely. Pretty much with any herb, if it's starting to get flowers, you can go ahead and prune it. So thyme is pretty much indestructible. It's very drought tolerant. And you can go ahead and prune that back, and it will go ahead and grow back for you. But once the herb flowers, the flavors of the leaves change. So try and catch it before it flowers if you can. Okay, I did see a question scroll by here. A great question about cilantro. Can you do the same thing for cilantro? You definitely can prune back cilantro before it flowers. It definitely does help extend the growth. Cilantro is a little bit different though. Moving right into our second tip, and I'll tell you why cilantro is different in just a second. Our second tip is, once you do prune these little basil stems here, a very cool thing you can do is propagate it. And Yvette, I'm gonna answer your question about how to store the basil after you cut it in just a second too. So you can propagate basil so easily. And if you're not familiar with what the word propagate means, it just means that it will grow roots from the stem. So you're basically creating a new plant from the mother plant. So let me show you what I mean here. I have some basil that I harvested last week, and then a couple more stems I harvested this morning in this little cute jar here. I love this jar. I got it actually at a wedding. People always ask me where I get these jars, but they had little centerpieces at a wedding and they gave them away to everybody. So I got a bunch of them from that. So anyway, all you have to do is, once you snip it, you simply just put it in a jar of water. And it's a great way to store it too. You can store it like this on your windowsill or on your countertop. It stays fresh for several weeks that way. Another way you can store it is to wrap it in paper towels and put it in the refrigerator. But back to propagating. Once you put your basil in a jar of water, it's gonna grow roots in about 5 to 7, sometimes 10 days. And you can go ahead and plant those in a new container. So that's a great way to literally have an endless supply of basil just from one plant. So you can see if I prune back this plant, which is super, super lush and healthy, if I pruned it back once a week, put the stems in a jar of water, I can go ahead and plant those out in the garden once they root, and I will have basil for years. And yes, absolutely, Santa Ana Road Wildman, free plants. So these actually I planted I put in water about 5 days ago, so they're not quite rooting yet. Now, what's super important, you want to make sure you change the water daily. So just dump it out, fresh batch of water, and if you add a couple of drops of worm tea in it, which I know a lot of you guys grow with the Vermistera worm tea, then it roots even faster. So drop a little bit of worm tea in it, just a drop or two, you're gonna have roots in 5 to 7 days. Once it roots, guys, it's so, oh yeah, and keep it out of direct sunlight. If your windowsill gets sunlight, just move it in a spot that is not so sunny, because that way the roots, you know, won't rot and it'll just stay a lot fresher that way. But once you get a good healthy amount of roots, and I wish I had one that had roots on to show you guys, but the roots are gonna grow out from the stem. And once you get a good healthy amount of roots, all you need to do, you take a little container here. I've just got some potting mix in here, a small little container. These are the little nursery pots you get, from Home Depot. You just poke a little hole in it, guys. See, I just poke a hole with a pencil. And then you just put that little basil stem with roots in it, once it has roots, in your little pot here. And very key is you want to keep it out of direct sunlight for about a week or so. I like to just propagate them on my windowsill. You can do it out in the garden if you want, but you need to, or you can put it in a little container out in the garden if you want, but you do need to harden it off and keep it in the shade. Once it gets established in here, it'll take about a week to 10 days. Once it gets established and it's growing very nicely, then you can just take it outside and plant it right in your garden, and you're gonna have a brand new supply of basil, a brand new plant. So it's a great way to get free plants, super, super easy. First tip, pruning. Second tip, propagating. So, so easy. Jack, I love your comment here. Yes, another herb that's super, super easy to propagate is mint. Same exact process with mint, and mint will root even faster. And mint is so incredibly fast growing that you'll have mint all over the place. So cilantro does not do that. So I had a couple questions about that earlier, about cilantro. But cilantro, once it goes to seed, you can harvest those seeds. It gets tons and tons of seeds. And cilantro seeds are called coriander. A lot of times they'll just drop right in your garden, drop in place, and then reseed. So cilantro is also a very easy herb to grow. But it is a cool weather herb, so it's a lot different than basil. Basil grows right now in the summertime. Great warm weather herb. Cilantro likes the cooler weather. Okay, guys, let me head over to the chat here. I see the questions flying by, and I really hate to miss questions, but I'll get to as many as I can. And yes, everything sunflowers, root mine and water with some worm castings or worm tea, and it roots twice as fast. In fact, I think I just remembered, I forgot to drop the worm tea in here. So I will go ahead and do that when I get into the house, but it definitely does root extremely quickly. And if you guys have never used the Vermistera worm tea, I highly recommend it. I've used it in my garden for a couple of years. Oh my gosh, it just grows like crazy. Makes things grow like crazy. So if you haven't used it yet, it's a great organic liquid fertilizer. And go ahead and use my promo code, Callie Kim, and you'll get a 10% off at vermistera.com. Okay, now on to the chat. All right. Here we go here, over into the chat. I'm going to buy some basil seeds now. Great, Santa Ana Road Wildman. You can buy my herb collection or my late summer garden, and there's basil in both of those. Purple ruffled basil. I've never tried that before. I've grown the purple basil, and I think some green ruffled basil, like the lettuce leaf basil, and that's really good too. It's a really, really pretty textured kind of look. Okay, how can I avoid the black spots on my leaves? And this is from Maria. Okay, I'm thinking you might be talking about black spots on basil leaves, hopefully. Okay, you know, that happens. Are you talking about when you propagate it indoors? Sometimes that happens when the leaves get wet and stay wet. A lot of times you might have aphids on your leaves, which you'll definitely want to spray off your plants with water. to make sure that those aphids fall off, and then use the neem oil spray. Another thing that really likes basil is the little tiny cabbage lopers. Those are the little tiny inchworms that you might see, and they blend in very well with the basil. So you do have to come out and check your plants. If you see little holes in your plants or little black droppings on your plants, that's a sign that the cabbage lopers are chowing down. So oftentimes a nice strong spray of water will knock them down. But if that doesn't work, try a neem peppermint oil spray, and I have a video on that that you can go back and check. But the black spots are usually from some type of rot. So just clip them off, and the great thing about basil is it will grow right back. So hopefully that should help get you some more basil growing. Okay, here. Pretty Alice Moon, I love, oh my gosh, the chat's flying by so fast. I missed it here. I think she was talking about, here we go. I love the worm casting and worm tea. I'm using it for the first time this year, and it's worked great. I'm so glad that you're having really good results with that. A lot of people have really been enjoying that this year and had lots and lots to harvest. So thanks for sharing that, Alice. Here's from Lindsay. My basil plants were doing really well. I harvested lots, but have since struggled. The leaves became light yellow color, harder and smaller. What can I do, and why is this happening? Okay, Lindsay. I'm wondering if you might have let them flower first before you trim them, because sometimes when you let them flower, the stems do become really woody and thick. So that could be the case. And sometimes just the heat gets to it, and you know, things don't always go as planned in the garden. But what you can do, if it's really hot in your area, basil does pretty well in sort of a filtered sunlight situation. So sometimes I'll plant mine like in between tomato plants, where it might get a little bit of shade and the sunlight will kind of filter through, and it seems to do very, very well. I mean, it's definitely a full sun-loving herb, but when the temperatures get super hot like it is today, it's almost 100 degrees out here, it does like a little bit of shade or filtered sunlight. So give that a try. But the good thing is, if your basil plant didn't make it, get another one planted, or trim it, propagate it, and get yourself some free plants. So hopefully that'll help you get some more basil plants. Okay, question here from Angie. Oh, I love this question. Can you take basil indoors in the wintertime and grow it year round? Yes, you absolutely can. Basil grows beautifully indoors. I grew some indoors last year, right on my windowsill. I had some in water, and I also had some growing in a couple small little containers. So look how hot it's out here, guys. This basil is already wilting. I just picked it like a few minutes ago. But yes, basil will grow very well in a windowsill in a container like this. It doesn't even need a lot of direct sunlight. And it's really fun to grow it indoors, because that way you have it right there in your kitchen just to snip and use into recipes. So definitely I would encourage you to get some propagating so you can get some small little containers growing inside before it gets too cold. Now you can also bring it indoors. Like here I have a 5-gallon container here. These are my Cali Kim containers. And by the way, guys, I know those have been out of stock on my website for about a week or so, but I just got an email right before we started here from Smart Pots that they're overnight shipping me some, and they'll be back in stock tomorrow. I'll have some tomorrow. I know I need to pick those tomatoes, but crazy enough, I've been picking them, but I'm waiting to do a container tomato video, hopefully filming it tomorrow. But they definitely do need harvested. But aren't these gorgeous? These are the Tiny Tim tomato. And these actually are in my late summer garden seed collection. And they're a super early kind of fast growing type tomato, because they're so small. So you can actually get a harvest in about 8 weeks. So pick up one of my late summer garden seed collections, get yourself some of the Tiny Tim tomatoes planted, and hopefully before the weather gets too cold where you're at, you can get a harvest. These are a determinate tomato, super, super prolific. This plant is only about a foot tall, believe it or not. So, and it is just absolutely loaded down with tomatoes. But if you have some basil growing in one of these 5-gallon smart pots, so you can get some of that going, get some of that growing now also, and then you can just bring it inside and maybe put it under grow lights, or if you have a sunny window, and you'll have a lot of basil all winter long. So it's gonna be so amazing to have that fresh basil inside when it's cold out. Think about that, guys, in the wintertime, how fresh and tasty that's gonna take. Yeah, it is all tomatoes, it's crazy. Okay, guys, I have one more tip to share with you, and people kind of alluded to this a little bit earlier. So first tip is pruning. Second tip, propagate that basil. And the third tip is make sure that you are fertilizing your basil. Now, it's not a super, super heavy feeder. It's not producing like tomatoes or squash or cucumbers. Those are all heavy feeder plants. It's more of a light feeder, but it's always a good idea, especially if you're growing in containers, to fertilize your containers every 10 days or so, every 2 weeks. And the Vermistero worm tea, again, is great, great liquid fertilizer. It's by far my favorite. I know a lot of you have seen such great results with that too. So fertilize your basil, because it is producing a lot of leaves, and the worm tea gives it that slow and steady growth. You could also use a fertilizer that's a little higher in nitrogen. I know a lot of people like to use fish fertilizer because it's readily available and it has a little bit more nitrogen. And nitrogen does help promote the green leafy growth. So that's also a good liquid fertilizer to use on your basil plants. So the containers, for me, I like to do it every 10 days to 2 weeks. In your in-ground garden, you probably want to fertilize your basil every month or so. So if your basil is kind of dying off, I know someone else mentioned some yellowing of the leaves, some problems with getting new growth, make sure that you give it a nice dose of some type of liquid fertilizer. You can even use compost. Just put it around the base of your plant, water it in very, very well, and you should see some new growth from your basil. So it's probably a really good idea to do that when you prune it, just to encourage that new growth very fast. So if you follow the three tips here, guys, that we talked about today, if you prune your basil once a week, and if you propagate your basil, my basil's falling out of my jar, grow new roots, you can propagate and make new free plants, and then you'll want to give your tomatoes a little feeding of some liquid fertilizer or compost every 10 days to every month or so for your raised bed. So that's pretty much my tips here, guys, on how to grow an endless supply of basil. So let me head over to the chat. I'd love to hear some of your tips, what you like to do to grow basil, and maybe some of your favorite varieties. Johnny, this is really funny. He's just got into work, and in the pharmacy, I'm being sneaky in the corner. That's really funny. Okay, I like that, but thanks a lot for joining me here. Okay, guys. Okay, Johnny, I appreciate that. Okay, Living Nay, my tomatoes get eaten on when it ripens. I see holes in them before I can pick them. Oh, that's so frustrating. So I'm wondering if you have, I know for me, rats are always a problem in my yard, and as soon as the tomatoes get ripe, the rats take a little chomp out of them. So we have had to set some rat traps around the yard, and sometimes I'll even put like a piece of an old t-shirt or a pair of knee-high pantyhose over my tomatoes. That really helps. Now, you might also, for just little small tiny holes, you might be having some birds come to peck at your tomatoes, which can be really frustrating. But the birds are really just looking for water. And what you want to do is just set out some little trays of water around your garden. Actually, this morning, guys, I just filled this tray with water up here, my little basil seedlings, to water them this morning, and there were little birds sitting up here just drinking the water. At first, I thought they were maybe pecking holes in my basil, but no, they were just drinking the water. So yeah, set some trays of water out around your garden, and hopefully that'll keep the birds off of your tomatoes. Let's hope so anyway, right? Hopefully you don't have rats, because that's a little bit bigger of a problem. Okay, let's see. Any more questions here in the chat, guys? If you can, put question in front of your question so I can see the questions. And if you're watching and you haven't yet subscribed, I just want to invite you to subscribe to my channel. We're all about growing your own food, doing it in a quick, simple, inexpensive way, being healthier. We love to have a community of gardeners here that we're just enjoying sharing good information with. And if you haven't yet, make sure you join the Gardening Coast to Coast Facebook group. I know a lot of you guys are in it already, but oh my gosh, isn't that group just a ton of fun? You can post pictures of your garden. You can just share back and forth information with people that that are gardening all over the world. And it really is a fun group. So just head over to Facebook, search Gardening Coast to Coast. Gary at The Rest of Garden and I host that group, and we're also posting updates on our garden. I post in there almost daily, and I'm in there chatting it up with gardeners all over the world. So make sure you follow me over there on Facebook, and also on my Instagram at CallieKim29. Okay, I saw a question scroll by here, how to get rid of whiteflies. Okay, what you can do, guys, to get rid of any of those chewing and sucking insects is try that neem peppermint oil spray. I posted a video on that. Maybe it's been about 3 weeks ago, and it's super easy to do in your garden, and it really does take care of the chewing and sucking insects. So watch that video for more details. The key really to helping get rid of the pests is prevention. So it's way easier to get rid of them before they even come to your plants than it is to take care of an infestation. So you want to spray the neem and peppermint oil about every week to 2 weeks for prevention. If you have a big problem with an infestation, you're going to want to spray it every 5 to 7 days, because the neem oil disrupts the life cycle of the insects, and the peppermint oil smell repels them. And I also add in some worm tea, because worm tea helps your plants be healthier, has all those really good beneficial bacteria and microbes. I know I say that a lot, but it really does help coat the leaves of your plants so your plants are healthier. If your plants are healthier, guys, they're not gonna attract the pests quite as much. So give that a go and let me know how it goes with the insects there. Okay, here's Johanna. Hello, Johanna, how are you? Can I plant your basil seeds for a fall crop here in New York, or is it too late to plant? No, it is absolutely not too late to plant. Now is a perfect time to plant a new crop of late summer vegetables. And I think, Johanna, I think you might have picked up one of my seed collections. I don't remember if it was a late summer or seed collection. But the key is to plant vegetables and crops that are quick maturing. So all of the seeds in that collection, I think I might have a little, oh yeah, I do have my little graphic here. Isn't this cute? We have these little graphics made up for seed collections. But the key is to really plant the quick maturing vegetables. The cucumbers, which will mature in about 6 to 8 weeks. The squash, the basil, what else do I have in there? Beans. Beans are a great one because they grow very, very fast. And I also have my little Thumbelina zinnias in there because those are very quick growing warm weather flowers. So all, I think there's 7 varieties in there that you'll be able to have this new wave of fresh plants. As your summer and spring plants kind of start to look a little bit ratty and die off, you'll have some new ones to take their place to take you into the cold weather. So order one of my collections, get some planted right now. Now is the time to do it, because that way you'll get a harvest, and it's always good to think ahead and always have something to harvest. And by the way, guys, along the lines of thinking ahead, I know it's crazy to think that fall, believe it or not, is just a month or two away, but it isn't too soon to start thinking about planting your fall seeds. So I also have a fall garden collection just launched last week. You can pick up the seeds on my website. Thanks, Ken, for bringing that up. My website's CallieKimGardeningHome.com. You can pick them up over there. And you guys, I just want to say, well, but back to the fall garden seeds. Get yourself some seeds started. Now, I'm starting some seeds indoors because my summer garden is still full. So I'm getting my cool weather veggies started indoors this week. That way I'll have transplants ready to plant as I'm pulling out my fall seeds, my summer seeds. Summer plants, all right, guys. Now, I just wanna thank you guys so much. I'm a very small seed shop, basically a one-man show here, and I wanna thank you guys for supporting me as a small business. So many of you have been so super supportive in purchasing my seed collections and my Cali Kim Smart Pots, and it really does help keep the garden content coming. This is my full-time job, so whenever you purchase on my seed shop and my containers and my seeds, or purchase through my Amazon links, it really helps me just make a living and keep the garden content coming. So thank you guys so much. I really appreciate it. Let's see here if there's any more questions in the chat before we sign off. Oh, here's a great question. How do you save a large amount of basil? And this is from Luz. So Luz, that's a great question. What I like to do, a couple different things. You can dry it. If you have a dehydrator, you can dry it. I love to make it into pesto, just in the blender. You can throw it in a blender with olive oil and Parmesan cheese, salt and pepper, and some of that fresh garlic I just harvested. And then you can actually freeze it into ice cube trays. So that's a really great way to have it over the winter time. And that way you can just throw it in your spaghetti sauce or in your pasta, on top of your chicken that you're baking or whatever. And it's super, super great, super easy way to save it. So hang it upside down to dry. That's a good way to do it too if you don't have a dehydrator. So anyway, that's a really, really great way to save it. Okay, Simone, starting your fall garden in just a few weeks. Yep, not too late to start that, or not too early to start that. And Johanna, strawberry seeds. I actually have never grown strawberries from seed. you really have to have a lot of patience to grow strawberries from seed. It takes quite a long time, and it's very, very iffy. You never quite know if it's gonna work or not. So I usually pick up some transplants from the garden center every year and get those going. But you can very easily propagate strawberry runners, which I have a video on that as well, to get free plants. Okay, I saw a question up here in the chat about someone living in Hollister, California. Oh, Santa Ana Real Wildman, of course. Living up in Hollister, should I start late summer garden or fall collection? Okay, great question. It's still a bit early here in California for fall. We typically don't get our cool weather until November or December. So if I were you, I would get your late summer garden started right now and start your fall seeds probably in September, October. Get them ready to plant in November, December here in California. Now you can, I'm starting them now because I'm getting everyone else going on the video series, and I will be growing them in the shade during the fall months because it's so hot here in the fall. September, October are usually two of our hottest months. So they'll be getting some shade cloth and get covered to keep them going, and then they'll really take off once the cool weather hits in November and December. So that's my plan of attack here in California. You can do whatever you want, but that's what I've done pretty much every year for the past couple of years, and it's worked really well. Okay, guys, a couple more questions, then we're gonna sign off, okay? Guys, it's getting hot out here, and yes, I do need to take a drink of water. Okay, April, I love your tip on hanging your plants upside down to dry them. I'm assuming you mean your herbs, maybe some garlic, and I've got some garlic hanging upside down right behind me there, if you guys can see that. And let me know what varieties of basil you guys are growing, what varieties you like to grow. There's so many out there. Okay, here's a great question from Rosie. What's in a fall garden veggies for Wisconsin? Okay, let me just explain a little bit about fall gardening. Fall gardening simply means that you're growing cool weather vegetables. So there's some plants that obviously are warm weather vegetables that you grow in the summertime, but don't think that just because fall is coming, you have to give up on your gardening. There's some vegetables that love the cool weather. And an example of some of those would be beets, would be some of the greens, like lettuce absolutely loves cool weather. Like broccoli, cauliflower, collards, all those are in my fall garden seed collection. I'm trying to think, I have 15 varieties in there. I should have brought my list out, but you can go out and you can go look on my website at calliekimgardeninghome.com and check out that collection. I know broccoli, cauliflower, I think I did put an herb in there. Yes, dill is a cool weather herb. That's in there as well. And lots of other greens. I think I have two or three different varieties of lettuce. I don't think I have kale in there, but you can get kale in the heat tolerant greens collection. But you want to grow those cool weather vegetables, and a lot of them in my collection there will also take the frost. But you want to get them established in the fall, like September and October. That way when the frost hits, they're not brand new plants, but they're good and established. They'll be able to handle when you get a frost and just keep on going, especially if you put some type of a winter cover over your garden bed. You should be able to get some of your plants to survive throughout the wintertime. Oh, carrots. Carrots are another great cool weather vegetable. So all good plants to get going now and to keep growing in the cool and in the, sorry, I'm reading the chat at the same time talking. Doesn't work so well in the fall and in the winter time. Okay, one more question here from Luz about cucumbers. Can I plant more of the Bushmaster cukes from the patio collection? I think you mean Space Master. When do I know when my first plants are done? Okay, cucumbers are one of those plants that I like to plant. I can never have too many cucumbers. I like to plant them every couple of weeks. So I've got some new seeds started right up here, guys. Some new plant seedlings going. And you'll know your plants are done when they're getting dry, when they're looking kind of not so great, and when you don't have any more cucumbers on them. If they still look nice and green and they're still producing, then just leave them in. But definitely get some new seeds going. And what you can do is, if you don't have space yet to plant them in your containers or in your garden, get some going indoors. So I had these seedlings started about 3 weeks ago or so. And that way you're gonna be ready when your old plants are done. You'll have some new ones to take their place. So it just kind of gives you a little jump. The other thing you can do is just stick some new seeds in the soil right next to your plants that you have growing. So I put some seeds in here, some cucumber seeds in here a couple of weeks ago, and you can see they're already sprouting and growing. So start from seed indoors to get them going very quickly, and then just stick some new seeds in the soil, and that way you're going to always have something growing and hopefully always have something to harvest. That's the idea anyway. So guys, it's getting hot out here. I'm getting very sweaty and hot. I'm gonna go inside and have some lunch and get a drink. I hope you guys are staying hydrated wherever you're at. Thank you so much for joining me. I know a lot of you are joining me on your lunch hours and from all over the world. So I really, really, really appreciate your support. It's a lot of fun to hang out here with you and talk about basil today. So stay tuned to the channel, subscribe if you haven't already. And Wednesday's video hopefully will be about this container tomato plant right behind me, some tips on growing tomatoes. So, all right, guys, talk to you later. Bye-bye.